Welcome all. We have already started our second lesson, that is plants, their structure and functions of each part of plant. So we are knowing what are the parts of plant. Yes, it is stem, roots, the leaf, flowers, etc. So before we proceed, we have already studied one part of a plant, that was the roots. We have seen different types of root. We have also studied about the seed, the part of the seed which goes down near the soil, which gets later converted into root, is called as radical. The part of the seed which comes above the soil or which later get converted into a plant or a tree is called as the plumule. So we will just proceed. We are going to start with our next part of a plant, that is stem. The stem grows above the soil from the plumule of the sprouting seed. Plumule means what? Yes, the part of the seed which comes above the soil. As the sprout grows in, the length of the stem gradually increases. If you have seen that if the sprout grows, if the length increases, the length of the stem also increases. Gradually means slowly. There are nodes on the stems. Can you see in the picture given alongside over here? Nodes means what? The part of the stem from which leaves, branches come out. Yes, it is a part of the stem from which the branches, the leaves come out. Okay, you can see in the picture clearly it is mentioned. So, leaves come out at the nodes. The part of the stem between two nodes is called as internode. If you can see, there are two nodes present and the part between them, it is called as the internode. Why? Because it is located between the two points. The tip or the apical end of the stem is called as the bud. If you can observe here, this is the topmost part of the stem. Yes, it is growing and that growing end is called as a bud. It is not bird, it is bud, B-U-D. Observe the branch of a plant and identify the different parts as per the diagram. You can go, you can see any of the plant nearby to you. You can just observe and you can locate or you can name that particular part of a plant. Okay, so we'll go further. They have given you one chart and they have told over here to complete it with the help of the following information. Name of the plant, thickness of the node, length of the internode. Sugarcane is not possible over here. Fenugreek. Now fenugreek also nowadays markets are, there are, because of the lockdown, there is no proper vegetables available. So, and they have told you to convert or calculate into millimeter. That is like you are going to see the shortage of it. So we will just see this later part. Okay, just we will focus now on our leaf. Okay, here is one diagram given to you. And they have also given you the three types of leaf here, which we will just go further and we will see what they have mentioned. Leaves grow from the nodes on the stem. Just now we have studied what are nodes. Yes, nodes are that part of the stem, or it is that part of the stem from which leaves or branches come out. So here what they are telling, so leaves are coming out of the nodes. Leaves are generally thin, flat and green in color. In adaptation, we have seen one thing, that desert plants were not consisting of leaf. Their leaves were modified into thorns and their stem were fleshy. Here, what are the basic characteristic of leaves? Leaves are generally thin. Yes, they are slender thin. They are flat and they are almost green in color. Not all, but most of the leaves whichever you see, they are green in color. Can you tell me why they are green in color? Yes, they are green in color because of the chlorophyll present in them. Okay, the broad spread out part of the leaf is called as the leaf blade. You can see over here, they have given you the naming part also over here. Leaf blade is mentioned here. Here you can see clearly. See this. So this leaf blade means what? This whole leaf which is there, the whole spreaded out part of the leaf which is mentioned is called as the leaf blade. Or it is also said to be as leaf lamina. And the edge is called as leaf margin. Margin can be easy for you to understand. It is also mentioned in the diagram itself. You can see a leaf margin means what? The border of the leaf or the surrounding of that leaf is called as leaf margin. Now leaf margins may be entire, they might be denated and also be lobed. You can see down over here, entire means what? They are complete. You can see here, you can focus here, they are complete, there is no gap between them. That's why it is called as entire. Here you can see it is denated. Denated means what? It's little one break, and you can see they are going little down, like some like mountains, they are rising, again they are going down. And lobed means what? You can clearly see there is a huge gap between them, and you can see it is coming up and down. So such types of are called as lobed. This one is the middle one is dented, and the next first one is called as the entire one. Okay, so these are the parts of leaf. You can also see the topmost part of the leaf is called as the leaf apex. Apex means the topmost part of the leaf, which is mentioned here. This part of the leaf is called as leaf apex. You can see the border of the leaf is called leaf margin. Now what are veins? Can you see that the line, fine lines are present in that leaf? Yes, you can see that lines which are present on this leaf. Yes, that lines are called as veins. And what is midvein? Midvein means the middle line which is passing from that leaf, which is dividing that leaf into two parts. It is called as the midvein. And what is petiole? You can see over here, the small stalk which is joining the leaf and the node, or which is joining the stem and the leaf, that part is called as the petiole. What is stipule? You can see the small leaf which is coming out, which is going to grow later. It is called as the stipule. And what is leaf base? Base means what? Where it is connected. You can see this part. This is called as leaf base. Okay, just we'll proceed further. The tip of the leaf is called as leaf apex. It may be tapering, pointed or rounded. Tapering means what? You can see in this upper part, entire, dented and lobed. It might be tapering. It might be round one, or sometimes it can be pointed also. Leaves of some plants have a stalk called as petiole. Stalk means what? You can see over here, the part of the leaf. Yes, the stalk which is present in between, which connects the stem and which connects the leaf, is called as the petiole. Okay. Leaves of some plants do not have a petiole. Some plants are directly attached to the stem, that is why they do not have a petiole. The portion of the leaf attached to the same stem is called as the leaf base. Base means we almost know what is base. Yes. The small leaves like structure which are present near the leaf base are called as stipule. You can see in this picture above, you can see the small leaves which are emerging out, they are called as the stipule. Do you see stipules in all the plants? Have you observed them? Just see whether you can see or not, and later you can inform me. Leaves of some plants have single undivided leaf blade and single midrib. Such leaves are called to be a simple leaf. What they have told over here, see, some plants, their leaves which are present, they are having single undivided leaf blade. Leaf blade means what? The complete part of the leaf. If you observe the leaf completely, whichever you are holding in the hand, that green colorful surface is called as the leaf blade. And if that leaf blade is not divided, and you can see a single midrib. Midrib means midvein, which is passing from them. Only one is passing. Then it is said to be a simple leaf. I think so this part was there for you in 6th standard. Simple leaf means what? You can tell it is having single undivided leaf blade and single midrib. Midrib means midvein. So they are called as simple leaf. However, leaf blade of leaves in some plants is divided into many parts. They are called as, or they are said to be as, compound leaves. If a stalk is having many leaves toward it, they are said to be as compound leaf. Simple leaf and compound leaf are two main types of leaves. Leaves are later, or their types are mainly two. One is compound and other one is simple. Okay, we'll proceed further. In different plants, the arrangement of the stem is different. If you see, the stem arrangement means the leaf arrangement on the stem is literally different. Some are alternate, some are opposite, some are rolled and some are spiral. So you can just observe here. Alternate means what? You can clearly see in this picture. You can observe here. One leaf is present, next leaf is present above it. Alternate they are present. One is here, one is at that side. One is again at the right side, other one is little above and it is again at the left. Another one is again at the right and little up. Another one is again at the left. Okay, so you can see now this is called as alternate. Decussate. Decussate means you can see it is spiral. Spiral means what? The leaves are present anywhere they want. They are totally covering that stem. You can see if one is over here, the next one will be side to it only. The next one will just go on completing the circle type. So decussate is also, it is also termed to be as a spiral one. The next third one is opposite. Opposite means what? One is at over here, the another one is at the equal distance. It is equally it is at the equal and opposite direction to it. The above one also you can see, same it is there at the same distance, and the next one to it, the right and left are at the equal distance. So they are opposite, and rolled means what? It is completely covered. Okay. So these are the different types of leaf. Their arrangement on the stem is in such a way. Now here they have given you two leaf. This one, or you have seen the banana leaf, the leaf of banana plant. How it is? Can you tell me how it is? Can you tell me that veins which are present in between, that small lines which are passing from that leaf, are they parallel or not? Yes. Of banana plant, if you have observed the stem, the leaves which are present, are they parallel or not? Yes. So such plant leaf which are having the parallel lines present, or the veins are in the parallel way, that plants are consisting of parallel venation. And if you see this above picture, here you can see the veins which are passing over here. Yes, they are passing and they are just emerging out from the primary, later than secondary, and also tertiary. Tertiary means what? Third one. From the main mid vein, they are just coming out. Later again they are just getting converted. So such type are called as reticulate venation. So the people leaf is divided into two equal parts by the single mid vein. You can see there is a mid vein present, the middle line which is present in that leaf, which lies along the midline of the leaf blade. Secondary veins arise from the mid vein. Secondary veins means what? From middle stem, middle that line, secondary branches are coming outside. Secondary veins are coming outside. So they are branched and form a network of reticulum. As such, part is called as reticulated venation. And if you observe a banana plant, banana leaf, they are having parallel venation. Okay. So the next part is flower. We are going to study this flower and fruit. We are going to study in our next lecture. Thank you.